If you're expected back at work in a few days with the easing of the COVID-19 shutdown, what do you do if you believe it's not safe for you to return? It's a big concern on the minds of a lot of workers out there. News Channel 13's Julia Denovan is live in our newsroom with some answers. Julia.
If your healthcare providers say you're vulnerable to the virus, your job is supposed to accommodate you. But whether or not you're fully protected, the answer is maybe.
Attorney Michael Kuhn says his phone has been ringing off the hook with questions.
People were just calling and curious about what their rights are under various federal and state statutes.
People with chronic illnesses, immunodeficiencies, pregnant women, or just people 65 plus. Kuhn told me if you're part of that vulnerable population and get fired for not coming into work, you can report it to the Department of Labor.
The governor has issued some sort of directive saying that you should not work, and your employer nonetheless requires you to do so, and you refuse to do so. You could potentially have claims against the employer for wrongful termination because of an articulated state public policy.
But depending on the situation, they could be deemed in the right for letting you go.
If you're in a position that cannot be reasonably accommodated, in other words, you have to be there physically, and the employer is taking all appropriate measures in the workplace, and you still refuse to go, the employer may have a legitimate basis to terminate your employment.
In the meantime, if you are vulnerable and find yourself out of work without pay, there are a few resources to help you get through it. The new federal pandemic unemployment assistance will get you $600 a week. Under the Colorado HELP Act, you can get 2 weeks at two-thirds your regular pay. And after those 2 weeks, you might qualify for regular unemployment if your workplace isn't following proper COVID-19 precautions like social distancing.
For information on how you can get access to resources we just mentioned, you can go to our website tonight. That's KRDO.com. Reporting live in the newsroom, I'm Julia Donovan, KRDO News Channel 13.